In today's video, I'm going over an in-depth tutorial on how to buy and sell cryptocurrency on the Coinbase app, how to set up its security features, and how to navigate the overall Coinbase exchange on both their app and website. Hey guys, this is Erik of Immersive Tech TV, and on this channel I review awesome apps, tech gadgets, and create app tutorials. So if you are new here today, definitely subscribe to catch future tutorials just like this one. Also, at any point, feel free to check out the description box below. I'll include a recap of all the points I covered in today's video. So before I start today's tutorial on how to use Coinbase, if you are not familiar with the app, feel free to first check out my Coinbase review video, where I first talk about what Coinbase actually is. If you'd like to see that video, it's actually part one of this series. Feel free to check it out in the video card right here. But if you're ready for part two and ready to start the tutorial, let's get started. I'll be sharing my screen with you. First, I'm going to be going over the desktop interface on the computer. Secondly, I'll be covering the mobile app. Okay guys, so once you create an account on Coinbase and log in, this is going to be the dashboard on the desktop version. As you can see, there is a chart here with the price breakdown, the price changes over the last hour, the last day, the last week, the last month, the last year, and all time. And you can see the different price fluctuations throughout the day, throughout the week, etc. And again, you can see the price changes for Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Litecoin as well. So right now we're going to leave it on Bitcoin. Underneath that, you'll see the recent activity, which just has your recent transactions of buying, selling, or transferring Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies from Coinbase. And on the right side, you'll see your portfolio, which just has a breakdown of the amounts in your Bitcoin wallet, your Ethereum wallet, your Litecoin wallet, your US dollar wallet or equivalent country's currency, and above that you just have your total balance of all the wallets. Okay, to the right of that you have your buy and sell tab, which is where you'll go to buy and sell cryptocurrency from the desktop exchange. So you can choose if you want to buy Bitcoin, Ethereum, or Litecoin. Let's say you want to buy Bitcoin in this example. Underneath that you'll see payment method. Here's where you can choose, do you want to buy with your bank account, with a credit or debit card? It's up to you. Now, if you buy with credit or debit card, the cryptocurrency is delivered instantly to your Coinbase account, but it is at a higher fee, a 4% fee. But if you purchase from a bank account, it's a lower fee, 1.5% fee, but it takes 4 to 5 business days after you purchase with your bank account before the cryptocurrency is delivered to your Coinbase account. So you have a couple options there. Now, let's say you want to buy with your credit card for instant delivery, let's say $50 worth of Bitcoin. You just type in 50 and it'll convert it instantly and you'll purchase the equivalent Bitcoin amount, which as you can see, 0.01909837 Bitcoin. You would just click buy instantly and it would buy the Bitcoin instantly and deliver it to your Coinbase account. As you can see, there are limits where it says increased limits. When you first join, there are limits to buying with your bank account, with your credit card account, but these limits can be raised by verifying certain things and just by purchasing cryptocurrency. And again, the sell tab, very similar process. You can choose, do you want to withdraw your money to your bank account or to your PayPal account? And again, the PayPal account is instant withdrawal, but it's a 4% fee, whereas the bank account, it's 4 to 5 business days, but it's a 1.5% fee. So you just have to choose which one you want. And again, you just withdraw the certain amount you want, same way as you would buy. One more thing I want to show you guys is, not only can you buy a specific US dollar amount, but you can also buy and sell a specific Bitcoin amount. So let's say you want to buy 0.1 Bitcoin, it'll then convert it to the equivalent US dollar amount. So it works both ways, conversion. Next up, we have the send request tab, which is where you'll go to send or request cryptocurrency to your Coinbase account. Basically, you'll just, in here, you'll go to your mobile wallet or desktop wallet, Copay, BitPay, the Jax wallet, something like that. You'll get the receiving address, you'll copy that, and in here, you'll paste it. And once you paste it in here, you can then choose how much you want to send. So say you want to send to that particular wallet, you want to send, change this to US dollar. Let's say you want to send $25 worth of Bitcoin. Underneath here, it'll show you how much you currently have in that Bitcoin wallet. And you can write an optional message, transfer, and you'll just send funds. It'll send the equivalent Bitcoin amount of $25. Conversely, you can also send, if you want to send Bitcoin, you can say, I want to send a fourth of a Bitcoin. It'll then send a fourth of a Bitcoin, and again, just send funds. And it's the same process to request funds. Again, you just paste the address right in here. And again, you choose how much you want to request, whether it be Bitcoin, US dollar, or other cryptocurrency within the Coinbase app. Next up, you have the accounts tab. And this page basically is a breakdown of all your cryptocurrency wallets in Coinbase. As you see, you have your Bitcoin wallet, your Ethereum wallet, your Litecoin wallet, your US dollar wallet, and the BTC vault. Now, I won't go into too much detail on the BTC vault, but essentially it's just a further layer of security for your Bitcoins. If you transfer money from your Bitcoin wallet to your BTC vault, once it's in the BTC vault, it's more secure because if someone ever hacks into your account or they have access to your account and they try to transfer out any Bitcoin, 48 hours will still have to pass before the Bitcoin transfer is initiated, which gives you time to cancel the transfer. If it's in your Bitcoin wallet and someone hacks your account, it could be transferred instantly. So it's just a layer of security, but there's a further layer of security I'm going to go over in a minute that I like even more than the BTC vault. Next up, you have the tools page. And again, this just shows addresses you may have sent and received from in the past, any recurring transactions that you set up, any other reports, as well as history of your buying and selling cryptocurrency on Coinbase. The last one is the settings tab. This is where you'll set up your user profile, any changes to your personal preferences here. And the security, this is the one I like a lot, security tab. Coinbase is really secure platform, so I really appreciate that. This is the one right here, two-factor authentication. This is a very secure feature. You want to definitely set that up. You can set it up through your phone or also through an authenticator app, such as the Google Authenticator app or the Authy Authenticator app. You definitely want to set that up as a level of security because if someone ever hacks, they gain access to your username, your email, and your password into your Coinbase account, they still won't be able to transfer any cryptocurrency without the second authentication factor, which would be your phone. So you definitely want to go into security under the settings tab, verify your phone, and set up the Google Authenticator app or Authy app to get that level of security. Next to that, you have payment methods, which is probably one of the first areas you'll be going to when you first create an account on Coinbase. Again, I've already set up my payment methods. I'm going to blur them out here for privacy reasons, but this is where it says add payment method. This is where you'll go to add your bank accounts, credit or debit cards, and your PayPal account to buy and withdraw cryptocurrencies. The last thing I want to show you is up in the right here where it says invite friends. If you click on that, that's where you'll go to get your referral link right here. And as you can see, if you invite a friend and they join Coinbase through your referral link, if they purchase $100 worth of digital currency, cryptocurrency, within their first 180 days, both they and you will receive $10 worth of free Bitcoin to your Coinbase account. So that's a pretty cool incentive to spread the word, share Coinbase with your friends so both of you can get rewarded with free Bitcoin. All right, so as you can see, there's a lot of functionality in the dashboard version of Coinbase. You can set up payment methods, buy and sell cryptocurrencies, set up two-factor authentication, and even edit your settings and personal preferences. Now that we've finished the first part of the tutorial, we're going to now hop on to part two, which is the mobile app version. Let's get to it. All right, so inside the mobile app version of Coinbase, you'll see it's very similar to the desktop version. You'll see it on the home screen, there's a chart with the current price changes in Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Litecoin. And as you can see, just like the desktop version, the charts will show you the price changes over the last hour, the last day, the last week, the last month, the last year, and since all time. Right beneath that chart, you'll see your cryptocurrency wallets, Bitcoin wallet, US dollar wallet, Litecoin wallet, and your Ethereum wallet, as well as the amounts in each wallet. And on the bottom, you'll see buy and sell buttons. That's where you'll go to buy or sell cryptocurrency. So let's say you want to buy, just click on buy. It will open up the buy menu and you can choose if you want to buy Bitcoin, Ethereum, or Litecoin. For the purpose of this video, let's say we're going to buy Bitcoin and let's say we want to buy $20 worth of Bitcoin. So you type in 20 US dollars. And as you'll see, it converts it instantly to the equivalent Bitcoin amount. You would be purchasing 0.00764190 Bitcoin. And where it says debit from, you can choose, do you want to purchase this with your bank account or with your credit card? Again, credit card has higher fees, 4% fee, but it gets delivered instantly to your account. Whereas if you buy from a bank account, the cryptocurrency will take 4 to 5 days before the Bitcoin is in your account. So it's up to you. And if you don't want to purchase a specific dollar amount, but you want to purchase, let's say, a whole one Bitcoin, you just type in one Bitcoin and you could purchase the whole Bitcoin as well. Or if you want to purchase, let's say, 0.333, a third of a Bitcoin, you can do that as well. It'll convert it to the equivalent US dollar amount. So that's pretty cool. And back on the home screen, you'll see it's also a very similar process to sell. Just click on the sell button. And again, you'll be able to sell Bitcoin, Ethereum, or Litecoin. And you just choose the amount of cryptocurrency or US dollar currency that you want to sell. And again, on the bottom, you just choose, do you want to deposit and withdraw your funds to your bank account or to your PayPal account? So you have options there as well. That's pretty much it on the home screen of the app. Again, on the side menu, it's just a summary of the same things, buy and sell, a summary of your wallet accounts. You can see the balances in them. And then, of course, in the bottom, invite friends. That's where you'll find your referral link within the app. The last cool feature on the app is this little bell in the top right corner. If you click on that bell, that opens up the alert tab. So basically, in the app, you can set up mobile alerts so you don't have to constantly be checking Coinbase to see the price of Bitcoin or Ethereum or Litecoin. You can set up an alert so if the price of Bitcoin drops to a certain amount, at that point, you could open up the app and buy. So you just click on the bottom lower right, add. It'll show you the current price of Bitcoin, which is $26.02. Let's say I don't want to buy any Bitcoin at this price. It's too high for me, but I'm willing to buy if it hits $2,400. So I'll scroll till I hit $2,400 and I'll hit create alert. So now the instant that Bitcoin, the price drops below $2,401, I'll get a notification straight to my phone from the app and I'll be able to open up the app and purchase Bitcoin then. So that's a pretty cool feature to have so you don't have to constantly be checking your phone.
And there you have it. That pretty much sums up how to navigate the Coinbase exchange on both the desktop interface and the mobile app. If you found the video helpful and would like to join Coinbase and give it a try, I put my referral link down in the description below where you can get a free $10 worth of Bitcoin on Coinbase just for signing up. So thanks for checking out today's Coinbase tutorial. Definitely subscribe to catch new weekly videos on more awesome tech, gadgets, apps, and tutorials. And if you'd like to see my review for my favorite hardware wallet for storing your Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies offline, securely, long-term, after you buy it off an exchange, feel free to check out my Trezor hardware wallet review right here. Lastly, if you have any questions on the Coinbase tutorial or the Coinbase app, feel free to leave them down below. I'd be happy to answer them for you. Thanks again for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.